I want to welcome everybody to our first ever on virtual celebration. I hope it is our last ever on celebration as well that we're doing on here virtually at the medical school. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Ken Johnson. It's my distinct pleasure to be the Executive Dean of the Heritage College. And it's so wonderful to see on smiling faces. And this is on for any of you who may have watched the Brady Bunch at some point. This is Brady Bunch on steroids, as we see on lots of smiling faces like on Crystal and Paul and Sam and others. It would take us our whole time to recognize the 376 people that we have online on here today. But I'm so happy that we were able to create a virtual celebration for this truly phenomenal class. This is really a historic time in medical education, and this class will be part of the history of care delivery as we continue to move forward. I have to say that although we can't be together physically, I'm really grateful to have this opportunity for us to connect virtually and to celebrate the hard work and achievement of this class. I say that Ohio University, and in particular the Heritage College of Osteopathic Medicine, is built on relationships and our care leads here on Byline, and it's an opportunity for us to really get together to celebrate and to show our care and admiration for this class. I do have a few housekeeping notes before we begin. I encourage you all to actually keep your cameras on, but mute your microphones so that we can hear all of the presenters. And I've been living in a Zoom world, listening to cats and dogs and kids and other things in the background. And so if you can mute your microphones, that would be really helpful. And I don't even really have to do this right now, but I will encourage you to use the chat room. And there's already, dozens of messages of congratulations and goodwill ongoing. There is one exception to this rule, which is award winners are encouraged to unmute and to say a few words following their award announcement. The entire ceremony, including chat, will be recorded so that you can watch it again and again and again if the spirit moves you to do that. Last but not least, I want to acknowledge that that we are at the mercy of technology today, and there are potential for technological glitches. And if we run into connectivity issues, please bear with us as we're working through those. We're doing our best under these special circumstances, just as I know you all are doing your best as well. Now, one of the things that we did with this ceremony, unlike some that we've had in the past, is normally part of graduation, we recognize those that are entering the military. I felt that it was important for us to bring that tradition into this virtual environment. So before we get going with the awards presentation, I'd like to take a moment to recognize that special group of graduates. First and foremost, for their commitment to medicine in the U.S. Armed Forces. This recognition will be led by U.S. Army Colonel, he has like multiple titles, so Colonel Dr. Mr. Todd Fredericks, who served as faculty advisor for the college's Student Association of Military Osteopathic Physicians and Surgeons. And with that, I will turn it over to Dr. Fredericks.
I just say congratulations to all of you. It's a great accomplishment to get through medical school. I am privileged, and it's my honor to recognize the members of our graduating class who've made the awesome and sacrificial choice to serve our country pursuing a career in military medicine. So I would ask you to hold your applause if your mics are unmuted until I've introduced all of them. They are going to be all from the Navy and the Air Force. Unfortunately, we had no soldiers. We have some coming up, which is a proud thing for me too, but I'm proud of every one of them. They have great futures ahead of them. They're all great students. So without further ado, Lieutenant Dr. Snow Adler, Ensign Dr. Tyler Gerwig, Second Lieutenant Dr. Anthony Brusnahan, Second Lieutenant Dr. Ian DeVal, Second Lieutenant Dr. Joel Hutchinson, Second Lieutenant Dr. Casey Norris, Captain Dr. Alicia Provost, Second Lieutenant Dr. Matthew Rausch, and Second Lieutenant Dr. Aaron Stover, And I think it's appropriate this time that you recognize these patriots by joining me, those who have volunteered to serve the cause and ensuring our freedom by serving with and caring for our members of our military and their families.
Thank you, Dr. Fredericks, and thank you to all the graduates for pursuing military and medicine. We're so proud of the commitment to our nation and all that you're doing and are going to do. We'd also like to take a moment to recognize a group that's near and dear to the college's mission, our primary care associates. This recognition will be led by Dr. Jane Balbo, who also serves as director of the Family Medicine Associateship. Dr. Balbo?
Our Primary Care Associates program is a highly prestigious and competitive program. Selected students spend an additional year at the Heritage College developing their teaching skills and conducting research. Such experiences have prepared these soon-to-be graduates for careers in academic medicine, where I am certain they will succeed. Today, we recognize 10 graduates who are completing associateships in primary care. The Athens Family Medicine PCAs are Dr. Chelsea Brunsman, Dr. Maggie Dade, Dr. Alyssa Girth, Dr. Xavier DiSabato, Dr. Amanda DiSabato, Dr. Sonia Johnson, Dr. Dorvin Beiler, Dr. Matthew Weisong, Dr. Brian Cost, and Dr. Darcy Hall. Congratulations to all of our 2020 Primary Care Associates.
Thank you, Dr. Balbo. And so one of the reasons I said this was near and dear to my heart is I actually took an extra year myself to do an associateship way back when I had more here and when I was in medical school. And these folks have taken an extra year, and I know how it feels graduating with a different class, and I want to just thank them for all their hard work and the contribution that they've given to the medical school. We're now going to transition to our awards presentation, and here to introduce the first set of award winners is our own Athens SGA president, Dr. Scott Wong.
Thank you very much, Dean Johnson. I was very excited to be able to participate in today's commencement award ceremony on behalf of my esteemed colleagues. Of course, to be more specific, I was excited because when originally asked, I heard that I would be roasting my colleagues in the departmental award section. After 4 years of medical school and accumulating so much material, to finally be able to roast my med school mates. What was actually said, though, was that I would be hosting the departmental awards section. Needless to say, I was disappointed. However, I am thrilled nonetheless. In all seriousness, the individuals awarded these departmental honors have excelled not only in academic medicine and received stellar recommendations from faculty, but also have gone above and beyond in areas such as research, publications, public discourse, and service to their patients and medical faculty. Here to present these awards is OU-HCOM's own Dr. Susan Williams, the Associate Dean of Faculty, and the one and only Dr. Stephen Wachowski, Departmental Chair of Osteopathic Manipulative Medicine. Dr. Williams, I'll turn it over to you.
Thank you. The Biomedical Science Award honors a graduate for superior performance in the biomedical sciences. This year's recipient has an outstanding record of achievement in research, including numerous awards, publications, and presentations. Please join me in a round of applause for this year's Biomedical Science Award winner, Dr. Ashley Patton. Ashley, congratulations.
I am extremely honored to have received this award. Thank you so much.
All right, good afternoon. The Family Medicine Award recognizes a graduate who shows the greatest promise of success in family medicine throughout outstanding work in the classroom and in clinical activities. This year's winner has made a profound impact as a Leroy Rogers Scholar, as a primary care associate, and through his various leadership roles. We're confident that he will make the Department of Primary Care proud as he continues to move forward in the world. Please join me in celebrating this year's Family Medicine Award winner, Dr. Dorvin Beiler. Congratulations, Dorvin.
Thank you, Dr. Olkowski. I'm especially grateful to Dr. Robert Newburn for being a mentor to me on the family medicine side. She was an inspiration. Thanks.
The Obstetrics and Gynecology Award is given to the student who has demonstrated the highest level of distinction in clinical rotation in the field of obstetrics and gynecology. This year's award winner has provided valuable academic peer support and has received outstanding clinical performance evaluations on rotations, earning honor marks on all OB-GYN audition rotations. Congratulations to our 2020 Obstetrics and Gynecology Award recipient, Dr. Emily Misbrenner. Congratulations, Emily.
Thank you so much.
The Osteopathic Manipulative Medicine Award recognizes a student who shows the greatest promise of future success integrating OMM in care. The winner of this year's award has been a wonderful asset to the OMM department as a primary care associate. He's an excellent instructor and has a wonderful rapport with patients. We take great pride in his commitment to OMM and wish continued success. This year's OMM award goes to Dr. Dorvin Beiler. Congratulations, Dorvin.
Back. Thanks, Dr. Olkowski. I'm especially grateful to you and to Dr. Kerger for your mentorship. I learned so much from both of you.
The 2020 Pediatrics Award recognizes a graduate who has shown tremendous promise as a pediatrician through both outstanding work in the classroom and in clinical activities. This year's recipient has superior pediatric knowledge and clinical skills. She embraces each challenge that comes her way with care and professionalism. Her work on several research projects at Columbus Public Health aims to improve maternal child health outcomes and close racial disparity in infant deaths. Please join me in a round of applause for this year's Pediatrics Award recipient, Dr. Chelsea Bittler. Congratulations, Chelsea.
My parents, family, friends, and mentors for all their support. Thank you.
The Social Medicine Award recognizes a student whose activities, advocacy, and/or research best exemplify the multifaceted mission of the Department of Social Medicine. This year, we have two students who are deserving of recognition. Our first recipient has been a champion for the marginalized in the classroom and the clinic. As a student, she initiated valuable conversations about race, racism, and equality. She sought out rotations that allowed her to care for the underserved. As a physician, she aims to advocate for justice and distributive justice in medicine on the micro and macro levels. Please join me in a round of applause for our first Social Medicine Award winner, Dr. Alyssa Girth. Congratulations, Alyssa.
As in true social medicine fashion, I want to challenge everyone today, run with the mod. We are done dying. Racism is a public health crisis, and I challenge you to be part of the solution.
Thank you, Lisa. Our second award recipient is also a tremendous advocate for the underserved. During her time at the Heritage College, she's been an outstanding campus and community leader. Her passion for improving health care for vulnerable populations is an inspiration to all. She truly embodies the spirit of the Social Medicine Department and will be an excellent ambassador for the Heritage College in the years to come. Our second Social Medicine Award goes to Dr. Crystal Prestel. Congratulations, Crystal.
Thanks, guys, so much. Thank you. And what an honor to be awarded after Alyssa. I just so admire your passion. And I think the greatest legacy we could have as students is to continue our passion for social justice and awareness as we leave OU and run with Ahmad.
The Global Health Award is given to a student who has demonstrated knowledge of the principles of global health, who has been involved in improving the lives of others through public health and other international activities, and is dedicated to moving the field of global health education forward. from Honduras to Nicaragua to Peru. This year's winner has participated in a wide array of medical initiatives around the globe. We believe that his keen interest and aptitude in global radiology education will positively impact global health for many years to come. The 2020 Global Health Award is presented to Dr. Jaewin Lee. Congratulations, Jaewin.
I'm really honored to be receiving this award and hope that I will continue doing everything that I have done to deserve this. Thank you.
The Special Medicine Award goes to a graduate who has demonstrated the highest level of distinction in the field of specialty medicine. This year's winner is an exemplary student who consistently garners outstanding evaluations from clinical preceptors. He is personable, well-organized, yet easygoing and militant in his pursuits. I have no doubt that he will make an excellent orthopedic surgeon. Please give it up for our 2020 Specialty Medicine Award winner, Dr. Aaron Stover. Congratulations, Aaron.
Throughout the journey, it's an honor.
So that wraps up our departmental awards. Now I'd like to turn it over to our Dublin SGA president, Dr. Nate Wilburn Ogletree, to introduce the next set of awards.
Thank you, Dr. Williams. Excited to be a part of this virtual award ceremony. So clinical education, where we were finally able to use our finely crafted palpatory skills to grab the residents and attendings the very best coffee and hold hands full of supplies for the procedures. But seriously, third and fourth year were some of the best years of medical education because of the new challenges and amazing experiences that came with finally getting into the hospital and to the outpatient settings. Not only was it fun, but it was truly where we became osteopathic physicians. The following group of award goes to recipients who have been selected by faculty in our network of clinical campuses around the state. These awards are presented by the representatives of each of our clinical campuses of their performances of the highest distinction. Here to lead us in the presentation of our 2020 clinical awards are Drs. Duke Starr and Dr. John Schreiner. Dr. Starr serves as the Executive Assistant Dean of Clinical Education. Dr. Schreiner is the Associate Dean of Admissions and Student Affairs. Dr. Starr.
Thank you, Dr. Ogletree. It gives me great pleasure to present the Heritage College Clinical Awards, along with Dr. Schreiner, to the outstanding students from each of our clinical learning sites. The recipients have been selected by members of their site teams, including their clinical assistant dean, academic program administrators, and division directors, with input from local trainers and staff. These awards are based on the combination of the students' performance, professional behavior, and personal demeanor over years 3 and 4 of medical school. The recipients should be very proud of themselves for this accomplishment, as we are also very proud of them. So please join me in congratulating the outstanding student of Cleveland Clinical Campus, Dr. Lena Costanzo. Congratulations, Lena.
Thanks, Dr. Starr, Dr. Kirstein, everyone on the Cleveland campus. Congratulations, everybody.
All right, congratulations. It is my pleasure to announce the outstanding student of the Cleveland Clinic Akron General Hospital, Dr. Saif Jamil. Congratulations, Saif.
Congratulations, Saif. Thank you so much, Dr. Schreiner. I just want to thank my parents and my family for their continued support, and then also all my friends for just continuing supporting me throughout the past 4 years. Thank you, guys. Congratulations to everyone.
And now let's offer congratulations to the outstanding student of the Holzer Health System, Dr. Catherine Marksberry.
Thank you to everyone at OU-HCOM, Holzer, and the
Katie, we lost you there for a second. Repeat that. The applause ran over you.
Oh, that's okay. I just want to say thank you to everyone at OU-HCOM, Holzer, and the Gallup West community.
All right, let's give it up for the outstanding student of Lake Health, Dr. Benjamin Burnham. Congratulations, Ben.
Thank you, Dr. Schreiner. I'd like to thank all my family and friends, my dad for being a good example, and my awesome wife. Thanks.
Great. Now let's give a round of applause to the outstanding student of the Firelands Regional Medical Center, Dr. Grace Everly. Congratulations, Grace.
I'd like to thank Mel and Dr. Preston, and I just want to say that I feel like the award really belongs to all of us who were at that campus, because we all looked out for each other. So congratulations to all of us, and good luck in the future.
All right, put your hands together for the outstanding student of Edina Health System, Dr. Heidi Johnson. Congratulations, Heidi.
Thank you. I want to thank everyone at HCOM and the Edina Health System, and I want to thank God for all that he's helped me accomplish. Congrats, everybody.
Wonderful. Now, congratulations to the outstanding student of Memorial Health System, Dr. Morgan Stalder. Congratulations, Morgan.
All right, let's hear it for outstanding student of Southeast Ohio, Dr. Allison Nostrand. Congratulations, Allison.
I just want to say thank you so much for this award. Thank you to Dr. Gwillem and Kara in Southeast Ohio, and to all my family and friends. Thanks, everybody.
Wonderful. Now, please join me in a round of applause for the outstanding student of Central Ohio, Dr. Michael Moran.
Thank you, Dr. Starr, and thank you to everyone on the Dublin campus, and hi to my parents, and thank you to them down in Cincinnati.
All right, it's now my pleasure to announce the outstanding student of Grandview Medical Center, Dr. Nicholas Van Benschot, Jr. Congratulations, Nicholas.
I just want to thank my family and friends for their love and support, and a big shout out to Dr. Hess and Dr. Roberts and everyone else at Grandview. Thank you, guys.
Now the outstanding student of the Massillon region is Dr. Alicia Provost. Congratulations, Alicia.
I just want to thank my husband and my family and friends and Dr. Culver.
Well, thank you. The outstanding student of Mercy Health, St. Joseph Warren Hospital is Dr. Samantha Bosak. Congratulations, Samantha.
I want to thank my family and friends and the faculty and staff, Dr. Culver, and the preceptors here at St. Joe's who helped me make this possible. Thank you for walking with me on this journey.
Very nice. Please join me now in congratulating the outstanding student of Mercy Health St. Rita's Medical Center, Dr. Albert Bowie. Congratulations, Albert.
Thank you so much. In my opinion, our clinical campus cohort was special to me in the sense that we were the inaugural class at Mercy Health St. Rita's. I want to give a shout out to my cohort for trailblazing the path for future students. I want to thank the faculty and staff of St. Rita's for welcoming us into their family, and also to Ms. Bonnie Hay and Dr. Nicholas Espinosa and really facilitating our success in attaining our respective residencies. Thank you so much.
Fantastic. Well, let's hear it for outstanding student of Mercy Health St. Vincent Medical Center, Dr. Kanane Lyne. Congratulations, Erica.
Hi, thank you. I want to echo what Albert said and definitely thank Bonnie, Katie, and Dr. Espinosa. You guys make us look really good. I also want to thank my wonderful boyfriend, my friends, and my grandparents, my mom, and my family. Thank you for teaching me to lead with my heart and be kind always and work hard. Love you guys.
Wonderful. And now the outstanding student for Southern Ohio Medical Center is Dr. Rachel Stocker.
Hi, everybody. I just want to thank God, first of all. I want to thank my wonderful husband, Kenny, and all of my family and my awesome friends that I made at OU-HCOM. Our APA, Jill Martin, and all of the faculty involved at OU-HCOM. Thank you, guys, and congrats, everybody.
All right, and last but not least, join me in a round of applause for our outstanding student of Western Reserve Hospital, Dr. Gabrielle Fredo. Congratulations, Gabrielle.
Thank you.
I want to thank my Westminster family, Dr. Russ and Felice. You guys are wonderful. And all my family and friends. I couldn't do it without you. So thank you.
Congratulations to all winners. Well, that wraps up our departmental awards. Now I'd like to turn it over to the Dublin class president, Dr. Michael Moran, to introduce the next set of awards.
Thank you, Dr. Starr. So our next set of awards pertain to excellence in research. And this is a special award for us medical students, as many of us do research. Many of us essentially complete it, but with all of our clinical rotations and all of the time that we're doing, have trouble really excelling in it. And so these students not only excelled in their clinical rotations, but they also excelled in this additional subject of interest that they're loving and researching. So here to lead us into this presentation of our 2020 research awards are Dr. Darlene Berryman and Dr. Nancy Stevens. Dr. Berryman is an associate dean for research and innovation, and Dr. Stevens is a professor of evolutionary ecology who just this week was named an Ohio University Distinguished Professor, the university's highest honor. Dr. Berryman.
Thank you, Michael, and good afternoon, everyone. As most of you know, research informs and transforms clinical practice. We are fortunate to have many of our students engaged in research activities. Today, we want to acknowledge two students who have made a lasting impact through their research engagement during their time as students. Both of this year's winners have an outstanding record of achievement in research, including numerous awards, presentations, and publications. It is notable that our first award winner is a dual degree graduate who recently earned a PhD as well as her DO. Her doctoral degree in, she also holds a summer fellowship with the Endocrine Society. This is a national award, a very prestigious award. For those who haven't yet guessed it, our first outstanding research award goes to Dr. Ashley Patton. Congratulations, Ashley.
Hello to everybody. This award means a lot to me for all the hard work that I've done over 8 years at HCOM, but I would like to especially thank Dr. Kelly McCall and Dr. Frank Schwartz, who were my dissertation mentors. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Ashley. Our second award winner has been published in the Journal of American Osteopathic Association and is an editor for the American Society for Microbiology. She holds a research and scholarly advancement fellowship with the Cleveland Clinic Foundation. Our second outstanding research award goes to Dr. Jennifer Brubaker. Congratulations, Jennifer.
Thank you so much. It's such an honor to have this award, and congratulations, Dr. Patton, as well. I would, of course, like to thank Dr. Beverly, who's been wonderful as a research mentor, and Dr. Graham, as well as Dr. Valente in Cleveland, as well as my family and friends. I couldn't do it without you, so thank you so much.
The Best Case-Based Paper Award is presented annually to a student whose required paper is selected as the best throughout the clinical campuses. The paper selected this year is a review of a case of a woman with severe abdominal pain who was discovered to have a superior mesenteric artery dissection. The paper discusses the importance of being aware of uncommon diagnoses for common presentations. The 2020 Best Case Paper Award goes to Dr. Aaron Stover. Congratulations, Aaron.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Moore. A special thanks to Dr. Gwillem and Dr. Epen for their participation in this award.
Well, congratulations to our 2020 Research Award recipients and really to all the students who got involved with research activities. That concludes our research awards. Now I'd like to turn it over to our Athens campus class president, Dr. Dustin Peth, to introduce the next set of awards.
Thank you, Dr. Berryman. It's pretty amazing to have three campuses, Athens, Cleveland, and Dublin, operate towards a common mission. Across all three campuses, many of our lectures, student and faculty-led communications have been consumed similar to how we are virtually viewing this award ceremony today. So we are no stranger to seeing each other's faces on video. Honestly, in many ways, medical school has prepared us for the unique challenges of this current quarantine life. We've studied medicine and can sift through false Facebook information, viral conspiracies, and share evidence-based facts with family and friends. We're used to sitting for long hours, studying, snacking, to be honest, gaining weight, and the hospitals and clinics were used to using hand sanitizer every 30 seconds. Sitting for long hours, snacking, hand sanitizer sounds a lot like my recent quarantine life, but I'm still trying to figure out where this toilet paper fits in. OU-HCOM, with three campuses, has allowed us to reach across the great state of Ohio and beyond. All three campuses have made countless, we at all three campuses have made countless lifelong professional relationships and friends that are now family. The Dean's Awards are presented to a graduate from each of our academic campuses who displays exceptional character and personal and professional conduct, maintains superior performance in the classroom and clinic, and shows unusual promise of future contributions to the field of osteopathic medicine. These awards will be presented by our deans, Dr. Beth Longenecker, who serves as dean of our Athens campus, Dr. Bill Burke, who is dean of our Dublin campus, and Dr. Isaac Kirstein, who serves as dean of our Cleveland campus. Following our deans awards presentations, Dr. Johnson will present the executive dean's endowed scholarship. First, let's welcome Dr. Dean Longenecker.
Thank you, Dr. Peth. I'd like to take just one moment to congratulate all of our graduates in the 2020 class from the Heritage College. But this year's Athens Dean's Award recipient is an outstanding mentor and a role model with a true gift for teaching. In the words of one nominator, he possesses the rare gift of expertly being able to take very challenging and complex topics and explain them to others in a way that raises their knowledge and understanding exponentially. He is a critical thinker with a commitment to excellence in every endeavor. And his genuine desire to help others is something that's among the many qualities that will make him an outstanding physician. Please join me in congratulating this year's Athens Campus Dean's Award recipient, Dr. Albert Bui. Congratulations, Albert.
Thank you, Dr. Longenecker. I'm very honored and humbled to receive this award. There's so many fantastic individuals in Athens. I want to thank the following individuals for their unconditional love, support, and encouragement in reaching for the stars. And that's my mom, my dad, Diane Booties, my sister, Victoria Cho, medical school friends, as well as OU-HCOM faculty, staff, and alumni. Thank you so much.
Congratulations, Albert. As Dr. Longenecker said, the deans are incredibly proud of all of our graduates, but as the dean of the Dublin campus, this fist bump's for you out there. The Dublin Dean's Award recipient has been actively engaged in campus life from day one. Her leadership roles include service as community outreach director for both the Student Government Association and the Student National Medical Association. She has been a consistent advocate for the college's underrepresented medical students. And in the words of one nominator, and I quote, her maturity can be seen in her approach to both challenges and opportunities, and she can brighten up the room with her smile. It gives me incredible pride to announce that the Dublin Campus Dean's Award goes to Dr. Jessica Motley. Congratulations, Jess.
Thank you so much. Honestly, this award recognizes my family because everything great in me is from the Lord and from them. I just love them so much. I've been emotional all day, guys, so bear with me. I'm so sorry. A big shout out to my campus dean, all my colleagues at the Dublin campus, and especially Miss Pam and Dr. Burke. They really make OU-HCOM Dublin a special place. They make it feel like home. So for that, I am extremely grateful for every opportunity to learn and serve over my time at HCOM. So thank you guys so much.
Woo! Get it, Jess!
Well, that's great. Well, again, on behalf of the Cleveland campus, I'd like to offer our congratulations to all of our new osteopathic physicians from the Heritage College from the class of 2020, and a special, special congratulations to the Cleveland graduates who've been our family for 4 years, and you'll always have a home at the Cleveland campus. It's my honor to now announce the winner of the Cleveland Dean's Award. The winner is diligent, reliable, and valuable resource to group learning. She's always prepared, self-motivated, and a great communicator. In the words of one of the nominators, and the quote is, she said, has one of the purest hearts and resulting deep passions to change the state of health for underserved populations. I have no doubt that she'll make excellent use of her training and be a huge asset to her team, her community, and to family medicine in general. Please join me in a round of applause for the Cleveland Campus Dean's Award recipient, Dr. Crystal Christel. Congratulations, Crystal.
Thank you guys so much. Thanking my mom, my brother, the Lord, and the school. Thank you so much for providing a platform where I can express myself, my love for the community, my love for community service, and my passion for justice. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Well, for us, one of our major things at the Heritage College is affordability. And a couple of years ago, I had the opportunity to develop a new set of endowed scholarships. And I just have to say that looking at the wonderful awards that we're giving out and thinking back about when we had one campus and now three and the ability to recognize so many more great doctors, it fills my heart with pride. When I had an opportunity to expand our scholarships, together we created the Heritage College Executive Dean's Endowed Scholarship, which is focused on students who have exhibited a high caliber of leadership and take part in various different leadership roles. They take ownership of their education and they embody the hopes that we have for all of our Heritage College medical students. Now, one of the things that was fun for me is I had the chance to call each of these folks individually. And some of this is going to be a little bit of replay because the recipients of this are Scott Wong, Crystal Christel, and Jessica Motley. Well, I want to say congratulations to all of you. And Crystal, it's good to see your brother who also was in the background when I called. So congratulations. Well, that concludes our Dean's Awards, and now I'd like to turn it over to SGA President of the Cleveland Campus, Dr. Uli Kachmar, to introduce the next set of awards.
Thank you, Dr. Johnson. Saving the best awards for last, of course, we now transition over to the All College Awards, where we will recognize special individuals who played key roles in advocacy, osteopathic leadership, professionalism, and more. These are individuals who are committed in upholding the college to its highest standards and have went above and beyond in order to do so. All students across all three campuses at the Heritage College were considered for this last group of awards. Our All College Awards will be presented by Executive Dean Johnson and Dr. Tanisha King-Taylor, the Heritage College's Chief Inclusion Officer. Dr. King-Taylor.
Thank you. I am so super excited to be here virtually with you all today. I'm going to blame Dr. Motley for getting me all teared up and all emotional this afternoon. That goes to you. I am going to be celebrating my 1 year with the HCOM family this month, and I could not be happier or more proud to be in this space with you and celebrate your amazing accomplishments. The Diversity and Inclusion Advocate Award is a new award this year. It was designated to honor a graduating student who has demonstrated outstanding commitment to social justice and support for diversity and inclusion efforts at the Heritage College and beyond. This year's recipient is a tireless advocate for diversity and community. Nominators noted her empathy, creativity, and her deep commitment to addressing health issues that disproportionately affect minorities. Congratulations to our inaugural Diversity and Inclusion Advocate Award winner, Dr. Crystal Christel. Congratulations.
Thank you guys so much. I'll leave you with this. Every time you see an injustice, do something. Speak up, move. The people that are being oppressed will be all the more for it. And every opportunity to be an advocate is a privilege.
Well, congratulations. The 2020 Osteopathic Leadership Award and Service Award winner is an incredibly high-performing student whose professional and interpersonal conduct has earned him the highest regard of the faculty, staff, and fellow students of the Heritage College. As a former SGA president, his passionate advocacy regarding diversity in medicine has distinguished him as a leader. He's going to be an absolutely wonderful emergency physician that works to serve the underserved and care for the whole person. And I have to say that I rely heavily on student leaders, and I've benefited from his leadership as well. So I want you to join me in congratulating this year's Osteopathic Leadership and Service Award winner, Dr. Nate Wilburn Ogletree. Congratulations, Nate.
Thank you. I want to just first congratulate the graduates of 2020. It was an honor to serve you in these leadership roles throughout these 4 years. And I hope to continue to lead by example on into residency. I'd like to thank my mother for having me, my partner and roommate, who's been with me all through this time, and thanks for OU-HCOM for just taking a kid, taking a chance on this kid from Dayton. Thank you.
Congratulations, Nate. The Kirkland Award for Professionalism exists to honor the memory of Dr. Robin Kirkland as a model of exemplary service and professionalism. Dr. Kirkland served as Assistant Director of Faculty Development and Assistant Professor of Family Medicine at The Ohio University Heritage College of Osteopathic Medicine from August 1997 to September 2012. This year, there are two notable awardees, both of whom have exhibited outstanding characteristics of professionalism. Our first Kirkland Award for Professionalism goes to Dr. Dorvin Byler. Congratulations, Dorvin.
I'm really grateful for all of the great examples that I've been able to see at HCOM, people, professionals who have shown me how to be a doctor who, in more areas than just medicine, in community leadership as well. I'm grateful for that.
Our second Kirkland Award for Professionalism goes to Dr. Grace Everly. Congratulations, Grace.
Thank you so much. I was really, really surprised by this and so humbled, and I don't know what to say other than thank you so much, and I will do my best, you know, moving forward to try to live up to this every day. Thank you.
The Osteopathic Heritage Award recognizes leadership, professionalism, and professional involvement, commitment to osteopathic principles, and skill in osteopathic manipulative treatment. This year's recipient embodies the principles of osteopathic medicine through service to the college, our community, and our profession. As a primary care associate and an OMM honor student, he was a consummate educator, role model, and mentor to students who followed in his footsteps. He incorporates the concepts of body, mind, and spirit in every single interaction. Please give a round of applause for our 2020 Osteopathic Heritage Award winner, Dr. Dorvin Byler. Congratulations, Dorvin.
Thanks again. I'd like to again really thank Dr. Wilkowski and Dr. Kerger for the way they showed me how to think about the whole person when you're treating them, think about the whole body as a unit. And I'm grateful for the education I've gotten at HCOM, and that encompasses all the different parts of a patient. And it will serve me very well as a physician.
Well, congratulations. So I have to say that getting through medical school is so much more than just the students themselves. And one of the things that I'm missing from graduation is often there's a time where we get a chance to thank those people most significant to all of us. My wife and I grew up professionally together. I was getting my DO degree as she was getting her on her degree in psychology. And I know how important it is for our significant others to support us, for us to lean on them, for them to hold us up. They share in our accomplishments. They help us on the days where we feel down. My wife and I, as we grew up professionally together, actually in medicine and psychology, I think it was a really complementary professional growth as we walked through this profession and our professions together. And I know how important and how amazing it is for folks to help support us. And I have to say, I wouldn't have gotten through medical school or this leadership role without this incredibly strong, beautiful, smart, talented person in my life. And I know how important it is to all of you as well. So with that, I want to introduce the love of my life, my partner, my friend, the amazing and incredible Dr. Linda Dunn Johnson, to present our final award.
Ah, thank you, husband. It is truly a great honor to present this award, and he always gets me emotional. And as I've heard about the stories of many of the significant others, I'm blown away at how incredible your significant others are. And I mean, Kenny is always so proud of the medical students, but they come with some really wonderful people. So it is my great honor to present this award. The Donna Jones Mortsugu Memorial Award honors and recognizes the spouses or partners of graduating osteopathic medical students who best exemplify the role of a professional's partner by providing immeasurable support. The goal of this award is to recognize these individuals who are often content to bask in the reflected light of their spouse or partner for their unwavering dedication and support. It is a great honor to present this year's award to Jordan Provost. Congratulations, woo-hoo! Jordan.
Thank you all so much for this award and supporting my wife and her endeavors for her medical degree and her career as a physician has been truly an honor. Thank you.
In her nomination, Alicia Provost detailed the sacrifices that Jordan has made in order to support her medical education and her military career. Sacrifices that included delaying wedding plans, turning down a dream job, and moving cross-country. In her nomination, Alicia wrote, "I am constantly amazed that he has done so much for me. But the most important thing isn't the housework or the cooking or even leaving his job to move across the country. It's the unconditional love." I can't look at you, Jordan. "And support he has shown me along the way, celebrating my triumphs, holding me through my tears, and having faith in me when I didn't believe in myself. Through it all, Jordan has been my rock, my confidant, and my biggest cheerleader. I don't know how I would have made it through the four most challenging and invigorating years in my life without my best friend supporting me every step of the way." Jordan, on behalf of the American Osteopathic Foundation and the AAOA, I am delighted to present you with the annual Donna Jones Mortsugu Memorial Award in recognition of the commitment and immeasurable support that you bestow to your partner, thereby enhancing her ability to thrive within the osteopathic profession. You truly represent the very best of who we are. I'd now like to recognize all of those incredible individuals who were and are the support system and lifeline for the members of our graduating class. Let's give them a round of applause.
Yeah.
Well, I have to say that last award always touches my heart pretty deeply on hearing the amazing stories on that we have there and the ability for my wife and I to celebrate our truly amazing students and the people that have supported them along the way. And I have to say I love that that award. And I wish that we had the opportunity to recognize and thank all of the other significant people in your lives. It's warming to me to be able to see folks in the background who are here at the same time supporting and celebrating with us, and it makes me feel a little bit closer together as a community. Today's awards ceremony recognized the outstanding achievements of a select group of students, but each and every one of our graduates is worthy of recognition, and we want to honor your achievement. To that end, please be on the lookout for a package of keepsakes items from the Heritage College, which will be mailed to each graduate later this summer. I'm also excited to announce a new celebratory website which honors our class of 2020. I hope that you will take time following today's ceremony to visit that website. One of my favorite aspects of our celebratory website is the recording of the osteopathic oath, which many of your student leaders took part in. The osteopathic oath is a contemporary version of the oath of Hippocrates. It affirms values central to all physicians and surgeons. To celebrate all of the new physicians in our midst, I'd like to end today's ceremony by asking all of the graduates to actively participate in this traditional osteopathic tradition by standing, raising your right hand, and repeating the oath aloud. The oath is led by Jennifer Gwillem, president of the Ohio University Heritage College of Osteopathic Medicine's Society of Alumni and Friends Board of, and she's the board of directors. Dr. Gwillem.
Doctors, please raise your right hand and join me. I do hereby affirm my loyalty.
I do hereby affirm my loyalty.
To the profession I am about to enter.
To the profession I am about to enter.
I will be mindful always.
I will be mindful always.
Of my great responsibility to preserve the health and the life of my patients.
Of my great responsibility to preserve the health and life of my patients.
To retain their confidence and respect, both as a physician and a friend.
To retain their confidence and respect, both as a physician and a friend.
Who will guard their secrets with scrupulous honor and fidelity.
Who will guard their secrets with scrupulous honor and fidelity.
To perform faithfully my professional duties.
To perform faithfully my professional duties.
To employ only those recognized methods of treatment consistent with good judgment.
To employ only those recognized methods of treatment consistent with good judgment.
And with my skill and ability.
And with my skill and ability.
Keeping in mind always.
Keeping in mind always.
Nature's laws and the body's inherent capacity for recovery.
Nature's laws and the body's inherent capacity for recovery.
I will be ever vigilant.
I will be ever vigilant.
In aiding in the general welfare of the community.
In aiding in the general welfare of the community.
Sustaining its laws and institutions.
Sustaining its laws and institutions.
Not engaging in those practices which will in any way.
Not engaging in those practices which will in any way
bring shame or discredit upon myself or my profession.
Bring shame or discredit upon myself or my profession.
I will give no drugs for deadly purposes to any person, though it will be asked of me.
I will give no drugs for deadly purposes to any person, though it be asked of me.
I will endeavor to work in accord with my colleagues.
I will endeavor to work in accord with my colleagues.
In a spirit of progressive cooperation.
In a spirit of progressive cooperation.
And never by word or by act cast imputations.
And never by word or by act cast imputations.
Upon them or on their rightful practices.
Upon them or on their rightful practices.
I will look with respect and esteem upon all those who have taught me my art.
I will look with respect and esteem upon all those who have taught me my art.
To my college, I will be loyal and strive always.
To my college, I will be loyal and strive always.
For its best interests and for the interests of the students who will come after me.
For its best interests and for the interests of the students who will come after me.
I will be ever alert to further the application of basic biologic truths to the healing arts.
I'll be ever alert to further the application of basic biologic truths to the healing arts.
And to develop the principles of osteopathic medicine as taught by my profession.
And to develop the principles of osteopathic medicine as taught by my profession.
In the presence of this gathering, I bind myself to this oath.
In the presence of this gathering, I bind myself to this oath.
Now I'd like to be the first to welcome you into the Ohio University Heritage College of Osteopathic Medicine Society of Alumni and Friends. Congratulations, doctors.
Wow, what an incredible group of students. I can't wait to see the change that you'll bring to the world as physicians of osteopathic medicine. Thank you everyone for joining us today. I noticed that we had approximately 400 people online with us. And congratulations to each and every one of you on your incredible achievements of your graduation. I think that deserves a round of applause. Faculty and staff, please unmute and join me in a live round of applause for the amazing class of 2020.
Good job, everybody.
Thank you.